Hello, what is happening guys? Mantas back with you again with some Mogul and Attitude content. And today I'm briefly going to speak about human emotions, right? So you can either allow your emotions to control you, or you can choose to control your emotions. And that's one of the fundamental things that a lot of people forget in their daily lives when emotions start rising, right? And they start making hasty decisions without even observing those emotions. And hasty decisions usually lead to faults, usually lead to failures or insulting other people and treating other people the way you don't even intend to. But because you use that emotion to make decisions, therefore a lot of things can go really, really bad. So personally, I started observing emotions at a very early stage in my life. I liked to stay analytical about myself. So Marcus Aurelius was a Roman emperor that lived at 2nd century AD, and he wrote a book that is called Meditations by Marcus Aurelius, right? So that specific book, if you haven't read it yet, I would highly recommend, especially if you're interested in Stoicism and Stoic philosophy. So that was the book that Marcus Aurelius wrote for himself, because that was sort of his daily journal where he would write his thoughts and he would write his ideas and his emotions, and then he would observe them, right? So the observation and anticipation is where the true power of controlling your emotions comes in. So because we're human beings, right, and we're always filled with emotions, we can't control it, but because we are alive, those emotions will essentially start rising. And emotion is basically energy in motion, right? So when that huge force, when that strong force starts rising within yourself, sometimes very, very heavy emotions can be uncontrollable. But you can summon that power of controlling your emotions when you start observing them, right? And when you start gaining more knowledge and wisdom towards what emotion actually is and what kind of impact it has on you as a human being. So one of the quotes by Marcus Aurelius says that if you are distressed by anything external, the pain is not due to the thing itself, but to your estimate of it. And this you have the power to revoke at any time. So what does Marcus Aurelius mean by this quote? He means that anything external can essentially impact the way you perceive things, the way you respond to things as well, but nothing external can have a power over you if you don't let it to have power over you, right? So if you don't allow, if you don't invite any external entity or words or actions to disturb you, to disturb your peace, it won't have any effect on you. So for example, when there's a storm raging around you, and if you stay calm, if you conduct yourself, if you control your emotions, you will be able to withstand that storm. And if someone is being nasty to you, if someone's being rude to you and then tries to insult you, the insult only happens if you invite, if you allow yourself to become insulted. And there's another quote that Marcus Aurelius shared, was that yes, you can. If you do everything as if it were the last thing you were doing in your life, and stop being aimless, stop letting your emotions override what your mind tells you, stop being hypocritical, self-centered, irritable. So by this quote, Marcus Aurelius wants to say that if you spend every day in your life as it was your last day, you will stop being aimless, right? Because you'll start focusing on every day, and you will be able to override your emotions and what the mind is always telling you. And in that way, you will stop being hypocritical, right? You will start focusing more on your ego, where you start focusing more on what actually matters in your life. So it's not about actually repressing your emotions, because that is a very bad thing to do, right? It comes with negative consequences. It's all about observing those emotions, right? Once you start observing them and you won't allow them to take over you, you will be able to make rational and logic decisions. So what happens when you're able to control your emotions? You can make rational and wise decisions, because the solutions that you will start coming up with will not be based on emotion, right? So for example, you become angry at a situation or at the person or at the circumstances that happen in your life, but yet you're dealt cards that you have and you have to work with those cards. How are you going to use those cards? What decisions are you going to make in order to improve yourself and improve your life? So our mind likes to jump from one thing to another, because mine in a lot of the philosophies and teachings and scriptures is usually portrayed as a monkey that jumps from one branch to another, right? So when your mind wanders from one thing to another, it can become very, very uncontrollable, and when it becomes too overwhelming and you can't control your mind, then people literally refer to it as you're out of your mind or you are crazy, right? Because when things become too hard to handle and you can't control your emotions, then you will start doing things that are completely out of normal, and that is only your emotions arising in your body, summoning that energy and manifesting itself. So there are ways to actually relieve your frustration, relieve your emotions, and there are some healthy ways to do that. So for example, martial arts, exercise, right? Crafts, playing a musical instrument. So all of your emotions can be expressed in different ways without actually intending to hurt other people. And these are the healthy ways that will not only help you to deal with your emotions, but you'll also learn something about yourself and about the skill that you're developing. So don't let your emotions control you. Control your emotions at all times. Emotions will arise because you're a human being, and you need to really start focusing on the triggers that basically summon those emotions, right? Once you start identifying those triggers, you'll be able to minimize them, use strategies, and change your environment so it doesn't affect you in an emotional way. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this little video, and I will speak to you next time. Take care.